Here I am explaining how the Coulomb force changes when the separation between the charges changes. You know that when the separation between the charges is increased, what will happen? The force will be reduced. The force of repulsion or attraction will be reduced. The force of repulsion or attraction will be reduced when the separation between the charges increases. When these charges come close, the force of attraction or repulsion between the charges increases. So here I am explaining when the distance increases or decreases, how it will affect the Coulomb force. Here I am explaining that thing. In this table, the first case is the amount of charges are Q1 and Q2 and the separation is R. So according to Coulomb's law, you can write like this, F equal to K Q1 Q2 divided by R square. That is equation number one. In the second case, the charges are remain same, but the distance is doubled. That means now the distance is 2R instead of R. So we are finding the new force F dash equal to K, charges are remain same, Q1, Q2 divided by, instead of R, we should write 2R, 2R the whole square, equation number 2. Then F1 divided by F, if you calculate F1 divided by F, that is K, Q1, Q2 divided by 2R square, 2R square, multiplied by, this will come as reciprocal, that is R square divided by K Q1 Q2. Okay, so K will cancel, Q1 Q2 will cancel. Here 2R square become 4R square. Then R square will cancel. So F dash equal to F by 4. So new force becomes 1/4 of the previous value. So that's why we calculated new force will be F divided by 4. That means when the distance is increased by 2 times, the force becomes 1/4 of the previous value. So as you know, when the distance increases, the force will be reduced. So here the distance becomes doubled, so the force become 1/4 of the previous value. This is the way you are getting it. So the force will never increase when you increase the distance, the force will decrease. So how much is decreased? The new force will be 1/4 of the previous value. In the second case, the charges remain same, that is Q1 and Q2. The distance is tripled, that means 3R. Then, as I explained like this, F equal to K Q1 Q2 divided by R square. Okay, then instead of 2R square, what will come? Instead of 2R square, 3R square will be there. The 3R the whole square. Then if you take F1 divided by F, that is K Q1 Q2 divided by 3R whole square, that means 9R square, multiplied by, here it comes as reciprocal, R square K Q1 Q2. Then these will cancel, R square cancel, F1 equal to F by 9. So the new force will be 1/9 of the previous value. So that's where we wrote like this, new force is F by 9. So when you increase the distance, here the distance became 3 times of the previous value. You know, when the distance increases, force will decrease. So here the distance is becoming 3 times and the force is reduced. How much it is reduced? It is reduced to 1/9 of the previous value. Force become F by 9. Here, in this fourth case, the charges remain same. The force is, it is 4f. How you are getting 4f? Here the distance is r by 2. We are reduced the distance. Now the distance is half of the previous value. Before that, before the distance was r, now it is r by 2. The distance is reduced by half. So how you are getting, how can you get 4f? In the same way, you can proceed. The first equation will be f equal to k q1 q2 divided by r square. Then the second equation, k remains same, q1 q2 remains same. Instead of r square, you are writing r by 2 the whole square. Equation number 2. Then if you take f1 by f, that is k q1 q2 divided by r square by 4, r square by 4 multiplied by the reciprocal of this r square divided by k q1 q2. K q1 q2 will cancel, r square will cancel. This 1 by 4 remains, it will reach as 4. So f1 will be 4f. So this 4 will come as numerator. So f dash will be 4 times of the previous value. So if we are reducing the distance, that means new distance is r by 2. In the beginning it was r, now the distance is becoming r by 2. So the new force will be 4 times. So when the distance is reduced, you can say the force will become more. How much it is increased? If the distance is r by 2, the new force will be 4 times the previous value. Now, in the fifth case, the charges remain same, q1, q2. The distance is, now it is 1 by third of the initial value. Now, it becomes 9 times. So, here the same way you can proceed. That is, instead of r by 2, you just put r by 3 the whole square. Then, you can see f1 by f equal to k q1 q2 divided by r square by 9 multiplied by r square by k q1 q2. This will cancel, r square will cancel. So f1 becomes 9f. So this is the way how you are reaching 9f. So if the distance is r by 3, if the new distance is r by 3, earlier it was r, now the distance is reduced, r by 3, then the new force will be 9 times. So from this, you can understand what, when the distance increases, when the separation between the charges increases, force will be reduced. When the separation is increased, what will happen? The force will be reduced. So from this you can understand that q1, q2, distance is r, the force is f. Now the distance is increased, 2r, 3r. The force is reduced by f by 4 and f by 9. Now the force is increased. How? By reducing the distance. That the distance is now becoming r by 2 and r by 3. The corresponding forces are 4 by 4f and 9f. So from this you can understand what, when the distance increases, force will be reduced. When the distance is reduced, the force will be increased. So these are the ways how the forces, the new force, compare with the previous value. So when the distance increases and when distance decreases, it will affect the force of attraction or repulsion between the charges. From that thing you can calculate from the Coulomb's equation, that is f equal to k q1 q2 divided by r square.